Welcome to the Academy Showcase. My name is Brooklyn.
My name is Carly.
We will be introducing Mr. D, Miss Susie, Mr. Orn, Miss Jenna, Mr. Eli, and Miss Julia. We have been having lots of fun in Academy. We have been having fun with martial arts, playing with oof and timbaloo music. We had dancing and hip hop and making shapes and buildings and putting things together in art. Thank you for teaching us how to do timbaloo music, martial arts and art, hip hop and theater. We hope you stay safe in COVID-19. Let's meet our instructors. Let's meet our martial arts instructor, Mr. Dean. Welcome, Mr. Dean.
All right, Mr. Dean, welcome.
All right. Thank you for the wonderful introduction, Brooklyn and Kali. How are you guys doing tonight?
Good.
All right. Well, I'll take a moment just to talk briefly about our program. Wisconsin Martial Arts and Fitness Center is a martial arts and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu school. And our program teaches bully-safe Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, which centers on controlling problematic situations and containment. And our traditional martial arts, which we teach basically our Little Tigers program, is 4 to 8 year olds, basic movements, blocks, just basic fundamentals of basic karate and martial arts that way. Our program is based on learning fundamentals, character development, physical fitness.
Hi.
I have had the privilege of working directly with Miss G for the past couple years. And in that time, we have built a cohesive, fun, and safe program that teaches our students independence, de-escalation tactics, courage, teamwork, and trust, all based on self-defense. Our program is all currently virtual right now. And for no charge, teachers and students can be a part of our martial arts program virtually and when classes go live in person. So we wanted to make sure that we said hello. We really, really appreciate and love our relationship with One City Schools. Thank you to Mr. Kerr. Thank you to Ms. G. Thank you to all the wonderful staff who continue to support us. And thank you for letting me be a part of you guys' program. I really, really appreciate it.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Dean.
This is our theater instructor, Ms. Jenna.
Hi, Ms. Jenna.
Ms. Jenna does art.
We're muted?
Yeah.
But it looks like we're unmuted.
Oh. Hello?
Hi, we can hear you.
You can hear me. Great. Hi, I'm Miss Jenna. I am the Education Associate at Children's Theater of Madison, and I'm so thrilled to be here. Thank you for including us in this wonderful program. CTM's mission is to engage, educate, and inspire young people and their communities, and I think through this program, we've really been able to achieve that. We created a 8-session video residency through the academies, which focused on using the 3 tools of an actor, your voice, your body, and your imagination to tell stories. We focused on what makes a story and creating your own stories. We used the stories the day the crayons quit as inspiration to create our own version of those stories. And we also really focused on the theme of compassion and how storytelling can help us empathize with other people. And that was really the core of what we worked on. So thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity. I hope you all had fun.
Thanks, Ms. Jenna.
Okay, go ahead, Brooklyn.
This is our art instructor, Miss Susie. Welcome, Miss Susie.
Hi, Miss Susie.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for your beautiful introduction. I am so excited to be here with all of you. Like they said, my name is Miss Susie. I am the Director of Programming at the Monroe Street Art Center. And I had the privilege of beginning the year teaching a few art lessons for our One City Scholars. And the majority of the semester was taught by one of our other art instructors, Miss Celia. We love our One City Scholars so much. They are the most brilliant artists that we work with. it was really important to us to create a curriculum for one city that they could use that really focused on artists of color in the classroom through a whole lot of different artistic mediums. We wanted all of the students to be able to see themselves in the art. For example, one of the things Miss Celia worked with our students on was a shape unit where we learned all about the artist Reggie Laurent, and we experimented with shapes using a variety of mediums and techniques, and then we made our own Reggie Laurent inspired collages. Throughout the semester, we learned about Alma Thomas, Jacob Lawrence, Shanique Smith, John T. Scott, and we just watched our One City Scholars grow and grow as their own artists. So thank you so much for letting us participate. We love you guys.
Thank you, Kelly.
Our hip hop instructors are Mr. Eli and Miss Julia. Welcome, Miss Eli and Miss Julia.
Thank you so much for that introduction. You guys are great. I don't think Eli is quite here yet, but that's okay. I can introduce us and everything. Me and Eli he's the founder and of Madison Memo, a local soon-to-be nonprofit focused on teaching the Black and Brown roots of hip hop and amplifying and empowering youth through dance in Madison. And we're like super proud of our diverse team of youth and like how far we've grown in these few months that we've been around. So I'm the outreach manager, and this is actually our first connection with One City, but we're super thankful that we got the opportunity to work with you guys and be able to teach these awesome scholars. So we've been doing 30-minute tutorial videos and for an 8-week session. And we start our lessons off with some hip hop history about one of the five pillars of hip hop. So it could be graffiti, knowledge of self, break dancing, MCing, or DJing. And then we do some hip hop technique and learn a dance that we work on every week, which we've been like super excited to see how they're doing with it. I think we've done about 2 videos so far. And it's been so awesome to just create them and navigate the virtual world. And then we're super proud of our scholars. So yeah, love you guys.
All right. Thanks, Miss Julia. Mr. Oran, are you ready?
Yes, I am.
All right. Welcome.
All right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me. It's a joy to work with all the One City Scholars and to be here and to have worked with Ms. G on developing this. I'm the founder and head of Timbalulu Music. I'm actually here in Brooklyn, New York. So I'm happy to see that we are emceed by Brooklyn. Mm-hmm. And the idea behind Timbalulu is that all the instruments come to life and speak through their music. So the children actually conceive of playing music as making their instruments talk. So one of the first friends that the children met is my friend Clara, whose last name is Net, and she happens to be a clarinet. And we've learned about a lot of different instruments, from the piano that's right behind me to saxophone, to the mbira from Zimbabwe, music from all around the world. And we draw on a lot of music from artists of color, including Miriam Makeba, Blind Willie McTell. We've been learning about Sister Rosetta Tharpe recently, and also Herbie Hancock, who has actually made a video that you guys can see where Herbie Hancock thanks the students for learning his music with us. So if you want to go to timbalulu.com, actually, we're putting up a lot of resources for the families on timbalulu.com, and you can sign up there and we'll let you know. Pretty soon we're going to build it out with a lot of resources, especially for the One City Scholars to follow up on the all the things that we're learning in school there. So yeah, thank you. And it's really a joy to be part of the community and to be growing with the children.
Absolutely. Thank you to all of our instructors. All right, you can go ahead, Brooklyn.
Check out what we have been learning in Academy.
My name is Ms. Greimel, and I am the Extended Learning Academies Coordinator here at One City. And this year we took all of our academies virtual. So it's been a lot of fun working with our instructors to develop academies that we can have for all of our students, both here at One City and also our virtual learners at home. So each week, our teachers and also our families at home can log into our Academy's website and find the date, and then they can find what Academy we're doing that day, as well as a lesson plan that they can just pull up. That's even been fun for some of the nannies that are taking care of kids at home to just kind of know what we're doing at school. So right now we've got children's theater, we've got Timbalulu music, martial arts, and art with Monroe Street Arts, and also a new partnership with Memo Hip Hop Dance. The challenge with Academies being virtual is it's totally different. Doing the lessons on a video is totally different than what you would do in the classroom. So it's kind of finding what's interesting for the kids and being able to make it come to life virtually. So what I do is I watch all of the videos and give feedback to the instructors, and we end up with a final product that goes out to the teachers. And all the teachers have detailed notes about what to expect, what materials are needed for the various lessons, and so everything is all set to go. Each of our instructors talks about our five habits of character: compassion, integrity, persistence, risk, and self-respect. Each of our Academy instructors has a learning target and talks about something that the kids are going to be learning and demonstrating in that lesson. It's been a lot of fun to explore people that aren't only right here in Madison, but that are further away because we are virtual. So that's been a fun thing that I wouldn't have been able to explore last year. So Timbalulu Music, he is actually out of New York. So that's been a lot of fun. We have Instructor Dean here with Martial Arts right here on the south side of Madison. Monroe Street Arts here in Madison. Children's Theater of Madison is doing our theater program. And our young hip hop group members of the Memo Hip Hop Group are also locally based here in Madison. So we've been having a lot of fun and hope you like what you see tonight.
All right, everyone, attention.
Yes, sir.
Bow. In return. All right, hello, hello, One City Schools. We have an awesome, awesome lesson plan for you guys today. We're going to be continuing on our theme of the grab and clinch escapes. This time it's going to be a single arm grab to the neck. What if someone puts their hands on your neck and threatens you that way? Okay, so we're going to do that. We're going to have a lot of fun today, including how we're going to start class today. So we're going to get started with animal crawls. Okay, so we're going to divide the class into halves. So one half is going to be on one half of the room, the other half on the other half. We're going to come together. Once we come together, we'll probably do an exercise, and then we'll back and set. The animals will go back, and then we'll come back. We'll go back and forth that way. Okay, here we go.
We do martial arts, and our martial arts teacher is Mr. Dean, and the rules are no kicking other people, no hitting, and no budging. And the acting stuff we do is we practice self punch, and we practice self kick, and we practice low blocks and the high blocks, side blocks too, and the inside scoop.
And push up.
The video stopped sharing. I don't know if that was supposed to happen, but it's not screen sharing anymore.
Our drills are usually push-ups and jumping jacks, and I do a lot of workout.
I can still see it.
Stuff like burpees and all that other stuff. Top blocks, we do the cross block, high cross block, low cross block, and an outside scoop. And we do top block, high cross block, we do the low block, and we do the inside scoop and the outside scoop. This is the outside scoop, inside scoop. And then our combos are usually reverse punches, reverse kicks, and high cross blocks.
The shout outs we did, he called our, he said our names, and then we did a celebration, and then he did all the other, he did all the classes.
How do you get a shout out?
By participating.
By participating, and when someone is hurt, help them.
Yeah, you gotta, by doing your best.
And by not moving around and playing.
All right, I am so happy. On this day, I get to give more shout outs to my people at One City School. I'm so proud to announce that these people have been recommended by the teachers of One City School to receive a shout out at Wisconsin Martial Arts and Fitness Center. So, fifth grade, blue. I'm sorry, 5K blue. Excuse me, 5K blue. Tyleek, congratulations. Awesome job. We're very proud of you. Arliana, congratulations. Awesome job. We are so proud of you. Siren, congratulations. Awesome job, we are very proud of you. Next, I'm going down to first grade blue. First grade blue. Matthew, congratulations, so proud of you. Let's see. Camden, congratulations, awesome job, we are very proud of you. Corey, awesome job, we are so proud of you. I'm looking at now the 1-2 combination class, here we go. Brandon, congratulations. We are so proud of you. Excellent job. Jair, excellent job. Very, very proud of you. Keep up the good work. Nice job. Simone, awesome job. We are very, very proud of you. Last but not least, I'm looking at the Scholars Academy. Scholars Academy getting a big shout out today. Shardavia, congratulations. We are very proud of you. And last but not least, Jaden Pryor. Congratulations, we are so proud of you. So thank you guys for doing an awesome job. I thank your parents for doing an awesome job. Thank the teachers at One City Schools. Congratulations, young adults, you guys are making a difference. Awesome job.
Hello, One City Scholars, hope you're all doing great. I'm excited for today's Timbalulu class, and here we go, you ready? Do you remember my name? Ordon. And you remember this friend? Kashishi. And this friend? Oof. And do you remember how we can say hello in French? We say bonjour. So can you show me your hands? Let's get our hello song started. Ready? Let's get a beat like this. Bonjour, au revoir. Bonjour, bonjour, au revoir. Bonjour, au revoir. Comment t'appelles-tu? What did she say? Kashishi.
Music. The instructor is Oran, and we are learning about all types of music And the instruments, some of the instruments is a shaker and a guitar and like this, and a trumpet, like those stuff. And we love it because we get to like use shakers and all different types of things, like a shakers, guitar, but we don't really have a guitar. But like all different things that we can make make a noise.
No!
Hey, One City artists. Today, we are going to be creating some artwork inspired by an artist named Reggie Laurent. Reggie is an abstract painter who creates very beautiful, vivid, colorful paintings using organic shapes. Let's take a look at his artwork. Wow, those paintings were so beautiful. Did you notice any shapes inside the paintings? Reggie uses both geometric and organic shapes in his paintings. However, the majority are organic shapes. So organic shapes are shapes that don't have rules, like geometric shapes, if you remember when we talked about those. So a square has a rule where every side has to be the same.
Hi.
But an organic shape has no rule. So organic shapes are things that are usually found in nature. Yeah. So plants.
That's what I hear. But ours is looking just fine.
Organic shapes.
Okay, good. Good to see you.
Humans have organic shapes.
Oh yeah, Martin said that this is masks are required at this meeting. Maybe you didn't get that.
I didn't get that.
So
memo.
Organic
Sorry.
Shapes are things that don't have rules and are always a little bit different. So today we are going to be imagining organic shapes to add to our collage. We're gonna draw them, cut them out, and then add them to a piece of paper so that we can make some artwork that looks just like Reggie's.
Art and the academy is art and Our teacher is Miss Thomas, and we do projects. One time we did a thing where we used the three hot colors, red, yellow, orange, and we could also use primary and secondary colors. And the other project is when we used paint sticks and we drew whatever we want to draw.
We followed the rules. We participate. We act and we do what she says. And
what are some of the art projects that you've made?
I made a dinosaur and a roller coaster and a roller coaster track.
We made a lot of stuff.
Yeah, we made a lot of stuff. Also, we did tie-dye.
Yeah. The other picture is where, the other thing is where we made our hand. We made a thing of our hand. We made, we traced our hand and we wanted to be positive or negative. And then a lot of people did positive and some people did negative. And we get to color, we got to color them in.
Which art project was your favorite?
The one where my favorite art picture, it was where we get to trace our hand.
What about you? What was your favorite art project?
Where we got to do like trace our hand.
Trace hand. Again.
What about I like about art academies is like you can do anything you want and you can bring it home or you can keep it.
I like about art academy because you paint and you draw and you do everything and you make stuff.
This is a positive hand made by Brooklyn, and she colored in with mostly primary, secondary, and then.
This is mine, which I did the outside and negative, and it's just covered all with all the colors and just coloring the outside, and Brooklyn's is coloring the inside.
With the positive.
And the negative.
Then this is the positive again.
Negative.
Our theater academy teacher's name is Miss Jenna, and our three rules in theater are mistakes are okay, try, and be supportive. And the three actors tools that we use are imagination, body, and our voice.
Welcome back, One City Scholars. Great work last time on creating dynamic characters, on rehearsing your story, and on telling your story of the day the crayons quit your own way. Today we're going to learn a little bit about sequels, and we're going to learn the story of the day the crayons came home.
But first, let's review my three rules of the room. Try, be supportive, and mistakes are okay. Additionally, let's go over our learning target for today. Our learning target for today is that students will be able to define a sequel and to identify the differences between the day the crayons quit and the day the crayons came home. Great. Now it's time for us to warm up our actor's tools. If you can remind me, what are our actor's tools? They are our voices, our bodies, and our imaginations. One City Scholars, to warm up our voices today, we are going to sing a call and response song. So I will be singing each line twice and you will follow along with me in the second line. There are some motions that go with it, so feel free to use your bodies to express those parts of the song story. It is called We're Going on a Bear Hunt. We're going on a bear hunt,
we're going on a bear hunt.
We're gonna catch a big one,
we're gonna catch a big one.
I'm not scared. Big tall grass, we can't go over it, we can't go under it, we can't go through it. Swishy, swashy, swishy, swashy. We're going on a bear hunt. We're gonna catch a big one. I'm not scared.
I'm sorry.
A big cold river.
We can't go over it.
We can't go under it. We've gotta go through it. Splashy, 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 splashy. We're going on a bear hunt. We're gonna catch a big one. I'm not scared. A deep, dark cave. We can't go over it. We can't go under it. We gotta go through it.
Tiptoe.
What's that?
A big nose.
Is that a big cold nose? And big dark eyes? And it's a bear! Quick! Back through the cave! Back through the cold, deep river! Squishy, splashy, splashy, splashy! Back through the deep, tall grass! Swish, 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 swish! And we're safe.
What's up, One City Scholars? My name is Eli.
And I'm Eva.
And we're hip-hop dancers from the Madison area. We're so excited to be here with you today to do some dancing, learning, and have lots of fun. First, we're gonna start off by talking about some hip-hop culture and what it's all about. Then, we're gonna learn about some technique and practice some skills on our own before we finally put it all together in an awesome dance. Our first I Can statement for today is I can name the four fundamental pillars of hip-hop culture and their ties to the Black and Brown community.
What is that?
Well, what's so cool about hip-hop is that it's not just dance. It's an entire culture that has so many different pieces that all stem back to New York in the 1970s in Black and Brown communities, and throughout time have had various influences by Latinx and Asian communities.
The four elements are music, movement, speech, and art.
And we'll talk more about this later, but for now, that's all you need to know.
Now we're gonna warm up and stretch. Hit it! Jumping jacks! High knees! Run as fast as you can!
instructors are Mr. Eli and Miss Julia. We are learning about eight count. Eight count is where you count like one, two, three, and like you do the dances. And routines. Routines are like just doing something like a dance. We love it because we get to dance.
So what do you think about the Hip Hop Academy?
It's good. We have the other teacher and it's okay. So the hip hop is actually just like doing one dance move at a time and just putting them together to make a whole dance of just one song.
Yeah. And then it keeps going over and over and over, so we understand a lot of the music. So when we go to the next one, it goes over and over and over again, so we can learn what to do.
How do you like it, Kali?
It's okay. With the first day of me seeing it by myself with you, Miss Gigi.
Uh-huh.
I mean, Miss G.
Yeah.
It was pretty fun. And then when I got to see it again, it made it more fun.
Yeah, you got to practice it once before.
Yeah.
Are you excited to learn the whole routine?
Yeah.
But you gotta stay out of the way a little bit.
And Miss Ruffin and all of our academy instructors. Thank you, families and teachers, for watching the Academy Showcase.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye.
Well done. Bravo.
Thank you so much for taking time to all of our instructors and to all of our teachers and staff here at Long City. And here's our
principal, Mr. Bob. I just want to say, great job. Scholars here. Great job, Ms. G. Thank you so much. Really incredible to have this kind of opportunity here, especially with the remote folks like in New York. So you guys did a great job. Dana and Ariana did a great job as our remote hosts as well. So thanks, everybody, and thanks for coming out.
Yay, bye.
Bye.